Yeah, our weather's nice. Shut up, she didn't say anything. That's exactly what happened. That's why you're paying for a parking, thank you.
What's going on right now, Corey?
something that I forgot a moment ago when I came out. Got a little rough, you know, talking in front of 50,000 people, no big deal. Got me some slack here. But you know what? One thing I forgot to mention was, again, to thank all of our volunteers, but the people that helped make this thing happen, the people in the churches, the volunteers.
The glorious wife.
And there was so much unrest, there was so much difficulty. And God's going to do some amazing things here tonight. I reflect back to my own story of when I was 14 years old, someone invited me to go hear a rock band. I went to Long Beach City College and sat out on the front lawn. My sisters and I, my friends.
Huh? Just send her your location.
We were passing around some marijuana cigarettes. I was definitely in my rebellious stage. I was not.
Just reach out and call. have seen over 350,000 people come down on this field and pray a prayer and become public stand to follow Jesus Christ. 350,000 people. And I'm going to talk about that tonight in my message that is titled The Sinner's Prayer. Hey, but I wanted to mention a couple of things before we welcome Chris Tomlin. He's going to do an amazing job.
Tender whisper of love. Yeah.
testify.
Thank you.
You've said when two or more are gathered together in your name, you're there in the midst of them. Now as we open up your word and talk about matters of eternity, the meaning of our lives, I pray that you will speak to people's hearts, not only here in the stadium, but to those that are watching online and on listening on radio and other mediums all around the world. Speak to them, Lord, as only you can. We commit this night to you now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Call the sinner's prayer that I'll talk about in a moment. a simple prayer for you. Simply ask Christ to come into your life, and I'll ask you to come down on this field and make a public stand to follow Christ. So you be thinking about that, because I'm going to ask you to make that stand in just a few moments. Let me tell you how I became a Christian. It was the last thing on my mind, age 17, 1970, going the wrong way in life. I was raised in an alcoholic home. My mother was married and divorced 7 times, had a lot of boyfriends. She was living the party, drinking lifestyle. She drank to excess every night, basically passed out. I had to grow up fast. I had to take care of her. In many ways, I was more the parent than the relationship. And I didn't want to follow in her footsteps. Before I knew it, I was in high school. I was partying with all my friends, drinking, getting drunk. And I'm thinking, I don't even enjoy this. Why am I even doing it? But then the whole drug culture came along. And we were told drugs would make us more aware. And there was some truth to that, because as I began to experiment with drugs, I became more aware of how empty I was inside. So it was almost like a process of elimination. I didn't want to live the lifestyle of my mother and the other adults I knew. I didn't want to live this druggy lifestyle that I found myself in. What was the answer? Well, I transferred from one high school to another because on the school I was transferring to, they had a strong drug culture, meaning that the people in charge kind of looked the other way. And so I went there to change.